the bad thing is that they don't have this cooperation between them that I saw here in UK. For example, in every SEA community, you can find national attributes between the communities, but at least they can cooperate between them. In Greece, you don't see this. You see the Sunnis have their own NGO, but represented in the government, and to have the dialogue between the government and in part of the Sunni Muslim community, but you don't see this thing in Greece. I didn't. The minority of Shia Islam, I didn't see any the persistences from the start. When I realized that I'm taking this way, I was Shia before I understand it. When I realized that the same things I believe, I was reading it in Mullah Sadat and Tabatabai's works, I was already Shia. So I couldn't choose something else because it would be like it wasn't me. But the first time I experienced, I knew Imam Ali as a great Sufi and a superhuman mind from the fragments I have read. I didn't know about Nazul Balagha, nothing. I read like I have did a small research from all the great Sufis of Islam. One of them I saw, it was Imam Ali. I only knew that. But when I became more into the Shia things and started searching who is Imam Ali and what he has written, the fragments of Nazul Balagha, it was... I think it was one of the most astonishing things that I have ever read, especially the most... it has very complex language, and it was also one of the greatest modules we have in the Hausa from Shaikh Arif that recites Nazul Balagha in from the Arabic text. And after that, he explains the meaning of the text of the Nazul Balagha. So it was especially this class of Shaikh Arif is one of the most unforgettable things we are doing in the Hausa. The Dua Jawsan Kabir was one of the most curious I have read, because when I read the story behind also that it was from Jibril, and how it was about the great thorax in battles and all the internal meaning between the dua, I was very astonished and loved it from the first time. Reciting duas is very common to the Greek reality. So the duas was one of the main elements that drew me to Shia Islam, the recitation of duas, because it is a part of my life. It is a part of my everyday life now. It's with my brother and my mother, we have passed so many things together and so many difficulties that at least when you have to do with blood, it's only love. You cannot do anything else. Blood is blood. I contacted a lot of times people in Iran, so I can go to study. I don't know from some years, but I wanted to be in greater touch with especially seminary studies and the core of the heart of Shia Islam. But due to the very difficult years that have West and in Iran, especially from Greece to go to Iran, it's very difficult. There isn't any direct plane. You can go only from Istanbul and then go to Tehran. I started to search. I know that I knew a lot of time ago that there were some institutes in the West, but I didn't know specifically about Birmingham. So, well, after a lot of research in the internet, someone told me that there is an institute in... I didn't know that it was such a big institute, or the biggest institute in Europe, in houses, seminaries, or it has such a big library with 2,000 books in Islamic bibliography. But he told me, you can go there and do whatever you can, because it's a totally different field from mine, and also it's in a different language, in English language. So go and try and see how it gets. So as I told you, if I want something, I'm going. I'm determined to go to the other side of the world. As also the Quran says, you can go to China. I didn't go to China to find education. I went to England, to Birmingham, I took the next plane and I came. From now I'm 5 months. I'm going to the second semester there. I'm living inside the institute. The great accommodations. Inshallah, from the next year it could be. It is being renovated, and it can host at least 40 students inside the campus. It's situated in an old Anglican church college that it became Muslim college. It's an old, magnificent old building with a grand garden in the back. The net page is www.almahdi.edu. Everyone can see the pictures of the magnificent institute, and especially the old Anglican building. It's very important. One of the most important aspects is that they didn't touch the small church inside. They left it like a small interfaith monument, and they call it the Masjid Malsala. It's a very beautiful masjid, and they keep it like it was before in the Anglican college, and it's welcome anyone that can pray in the one God inside. He can come and pray. It was one of the greatest interfaith messages of the institute. Knowing only very few classes, because it's my second semester that starts from the next week, the institute combines the seminaries of classical Islamic seminaries like Najaf or Qum or Karbala, Mantiq, Arabic language, Hadith, Fiqh, Islamic philosophy, Irfan, combines also with Western education from academic institutes, Islamic philosophy, history of Islamic law, Western philosophy. For example, for me, one of the best classes that we had in the first year was Western philosophy from Sai Karif, and also from Sai Karif his hadith recitings of Imam Ali from Najul Balagha. I think when you, it's like I cannot describe the feeling when you have someone to be inside the seminaries. Everyone from the big scholars we have, it's about at least 10-15 years. They had the biggest professor. They were in Najaf, in Qom. They are passed all through all the seminaries. They became Hujjatul Islam, and then they did a PhD maybe in the West. They have all the experience and studies under great Ayatollah scholars, so they can transfer us all the magic from the texts, not to be just draw solid texts, to be something alive, and to become alive also inside us, in our minds and our hearts. It's one of my future goals is to go, I don't know for how much, but I want to continue the studies. I want to continue the studies, especially in CUM. Especially in CUM. I want to go because I'm more close to the Iranian school of thought, and I like Farsi language very much. That's why I'm the from the first year I'm the only student that has the Farsi class. It's a thing of choice. It's not in our module. If you want it, you can follow it in the afternoon. For example, it's not in the same core with the other. But because I like the language, I wanted to learn the Farsi language. I like Haves, Haves Shirazi, for example. All the Diwan are great. A lot of people find this curious because, they told me how you are interested in Jewish mysticism and you like classical Hebrew, and then at the end you are you're learning Farsi, and you are because of the Persian mysticism you are coming into Shia Islam. And told them that wisdom is wisdom in everywhere. I don't care about politics of today. Since I became a Muslim, I had to be more, especially in Greece, to be more aware from the people, because you cannot say openly these things. And also, it's a bit misunderstanding, because from the one point you have from Greeks or friends of, I lost a lot of friends and relatives from my conversion. But I didn't care, because as I told you, if I want something, I'm doing it. After a lot of thought, I done it, and I don't care if someone follows me. If someone follows me and he likes me how I am, it's okay. But I don't care if someone doesn't like it. And also, when you're coming into the Muslim community, you have some misunderstandings from the Muslim communities, because a revert is something different. In every ethnical community, you have specific Shia Islam with the specific Islamic culture. Every community has his own culture. The Greeks have their own culture. That's why I think the reverts must play a very positive role in Shia Islam, being the messengers between the Shia communities and between Christians and Islam. Like me, for example, I was Orthodox Christian, now I'm Shia Muslim. Because we are not care about, at least the majority of the reverts I know, don't care about Shia, the politics, and they don't bind ethnically in any Shia minority. So, because you are your own minority, you are a revert. So I think they can play a very important role in inside the Muslim community. The biggest elements that it always wins is the ethnic.